We all set up, yeah?
Yeah. Testing. 1, 2.
1, 2. 1, 2. All good.
Interview with Mark Byrne taking place now.
My name's Mark Byrne. I'm 19. I'm from Wicklow. And I live in Bray. I also go to IADT and I do business management, which I'm finding very good.
How do you find your friends in the course?
You know, when I started, I didn't know anyone. But as months goes on, you know, learn a bit more about people, make good friends, go on nights out and all, enjoy it. Yeah, I say it's really good, yeah.
So you say it's the social scene that you've become fond of?
Yeah. Like, there's... You always get down to the nitty-gritty when you're in class, but as soon as class ends, the social life comes out, and you go with the flow, you enjoy it, go out with the lads, have the crack. It's all good.
So when the Berlin trip came, you decided not to go?
Yes. That was a good opportunity to get closer with my college mates. But for many reasons, I did not attend, which is... I would say regret.
Mark Byrne decided not to come to Berlin via his own choice, and then he proceeded to end up being here by himself. Was there a moment that you missed Mark, or you thought maybe someone like Mark was missing from the trip?
Well, I don't know if I missed him as per se, but it was good to go on the trip and just kind of get to know everyone a lot better on my course. And I think he would have loved to be on it himself, which is, he said that to us all, and he does regret not going on it because it was a great trip and everyone enjoyed himself.
You know, obviously the trip was cool, but it would have been nice to have the whole course there, if you know what I mean. Like, it wasn't, like, obviously you won't get too much of a miss because people
have an iPhone here.
I don't really know Mark from his thumb, but it would have been brighter if our whole class was there, I guess.
They all came back and said how good it was, and I was left to college by myself, no one to talk to, so it was a bit of a downer, if you could say that.
And how did that make you feel?
Lonely. Like, a whole week going talking to no one, just going to class, listening to my lecturers. Like, it's not the same. You need people there. Like, going on lunch breaks by myself to the canteen, just sitting there by myself, like, it's quite sad, depressing, you know.
What did you do when everybody was gone?
Just did my work, tried to catch up on what I'm lacking in behind, and, you know, just try get my mind off them having the time of their lives in Berlin, you know, just...
And it was the time of their lives.
Yeah, I've heard all about it, yeah. That is probably one of the biggest regrets of this year I've probably made.
Ever?
Up there.
If you could go back in time, is there anything you'd change?
Oh, I'd go on the trip. Like, 100%. After seeing what they've been like coming back, like, they've all grown closer as a group. And then there's just me who's didn't go, you know. Quite sad, really. It's quite sad. Another thing, issue was work, and I didn't think I'd get time off, but it turns out I actually had holidays the week they went, so that made it even worse. So I wasn't even going to work to get my mind off of it.
So you just sat at home?
Yep.
No friends.
Not even my friends from school, because they all work. So I literally just went to college, came home, watched telly, do assignments, whatever, go to bed, rinse and repeat the whole week.
And have you been able to get your mind off it since it happened?
Since they came back, I can't really, because that's all there's to talk about this week. So I've just been listening to all the stories, and I've been like, well, I do not understand anything that's going on right now.
Oh, Berlin was amazing. It was like so good. Like, I really enjoyed it. I feel bad to anyone who missed it, but like, really enjoyed myself. The water park, amazing. The drinks, amazing. The nights, amazing. Wow. Wish I could go back. Why do you keep going on about
Mark? Who's that guy?
Who's Mark?
I mean, like, the Berlin trip was really good. Like, we were there for a short amount of time, and like, I don't know, like, there was a nice group of people there It was a nice four of us to a room, which was kind of like, if it had been more, we would have to split into two separate rooms. And I think it was just kind of a really good amount of people that were there, and we went out drinking, like perfect size for taxis and stuff, and like it was just really good fun all together. Like, we ended up going out and seeing a lot of sights and stuff like that. I really enjoyed myself. Oh yeah, well, I mean, like, we're not really friends, like I don't really get on with them too well.
He was crying in the toilet.
It's a very sad week, I'm gonna say. Yeah, because it's just, it's annoying, you know. Like, no one else I've known been in that position so far, where they've gone to college and had no one to talk to for more than a day, because, you know, we're all such a tight group of mates. Like, we all just get along really well, but it seems all you have gotten closer together. And now I'm lacking behind.
Mark's my guy. I felt him here. But he wasn't here. He was at home.
You alright, Mark? I'm fine!
Well, I didn't go, but no one seems to care because it's all about Mark now.
You turn the corner.
Yeah, I'd say so. Looking back on it, you know, obviously I have my regrets, but you can't turn back time. You know, they're still all my friends. There's going to be more opportunities for me in the future to go on trips, hopefully, and I won't miss it next time. I won't make that mistake again, I'm sure.
This is Fear of Missing Out, a Mark Byrne story.